The Colgate Comedy Hour, starring Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis, with their guest, Patti Lewis, the four stepbrothers, Danny Arnold, Sue Bird and Sylvia Seep, presented by the Colgate Palmolive Peat Company, makers of Colgate Dental Cream, Palmolive Brushless Shave Cream, new Twin Power Fam. And Palmolive Soap. And now, the Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis Show.
Oh, I'm so excited. What a great day for the hotel. Two of Hollywood's biggest stars are coming here to stay. Now, we'll put them in the royal suite. Send up flowers, champagne, caviar. Well, here they are now. Janet Lee, Charlie Turner.
I'm going to tell him. You know, I saw you in Flesh and Fury with the muscles. You knock out the guys. I saw you. I know all this. Saw you in there.
Get him off the stage.
I'm going to do it, Jerry.
The prince that was a gun if you saw him that.
Sure, you stabbed all those guys. I know you're a big and
football,
strong.
Football, all American.
I'm going to tell him,
well,
Jerry.
Get him off the stage.
All American. And you, all those big guys, you know, nice and strong. Good to see you, Tony. Yes, sir.
I can't do a thing with this boy. See what you can do with that cat.
Get off the stage.
I'm going to tell her
Get
right
her
now
off.
To get off the stage. Janet, you've been...
Jerry, get her off the stage.
Right now, Dean, you're going to be strong and firm.
Yeah.
All right, well, hold Janet. Janet.
Get off the stage.
Get off. No, tell
I'm
her.
Tell her.
All right, Janet, now look. Let's stop kidding around, Janet. You gotta get off the stage, Janet. Now what do you got to say for yourself?
Well, how was that?
I like it. I like it.
I've never been so insulted in all my life. I'm leaving.
So am I. Me too.
Well, how do you like that? They all left me alone like this. I think that it would be a nice thing because it's the beginning of the show for us to say we want to thank Mr. Dore Sherry of Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer for Janet Lee, and we'd like to thank Mr. Bill Getz of Universal International for Tony Curtis, allowing them to make their first TV appearance on our show. Our good friends, Tony Curtis, Janet Lee. A nice hand for the wonderful people. I know them personal. I see them in the movies and all that. Anyhow, right about here, ladies and gentlemen, you know, all the shows on television, they thank magazines for wonderful things they've done for them. Well, Dean and I, right about here, we would like to thank Look Magazine and, of course, Shap Shapiro and his wonderful staff. Look Magazine, in their current issue, has nothing about Dean and I. Not a thing, but we want to thank them anyhow because they're such a wonderful magazine, and in the event that they like what we're saying now, if you put our picture on the cover, we'd appreciate it because on the inside, you got to look through the pages and everything like that. So if you'll do that, we'd appreciate it a lot.
Is this your story?
I'm sorry, Adams, but we picked another man for the job.
Or is this your story?
Sorry, John. I can't see you. I'm busy.
Then stop. You may be at fault. And Colgate Dental Cream may be your answer. Latest tests prove just one brushing with Colgate Dental Cream removes up to 85% of decay and odor-causing bacteria. Yes, science proves just one brushing with Colgate's instantly stops unpleasing breath in 7 out of 10 cases that originate in the mouth.
What about tooth decay?
If you really want to stop tooth decay, be sure to follow the Colgate way. Over a 2-year period, scientific tests showed the Colgate way of brushing teeth right after eating stopped more decay for more people than ever before reported in dentifrice history. Just look into this X-ray viewer. X-rays like this showed no new cavities whatever for almost 2 out of 3 people. Remember, only the Colgate way does all three. Cleans your breath while it cleans your teeth and stops most tooth decay.
Brush your teeth with Colgate. Colgate Dental Cream, it cleans your breath.
What a toothpaste.
While it cleans your teeth.
Well, why don't you get up and join in the fun?
I'm waiting for my husband. He just took our little son to the shooting gallery.
Well, make sure he pays a visit to the arcade. Children love it.
Hi, sweetie.
Well, did you have fun? Where's Rodney?
I left him in the shooting gallery.
What? You left that little boy all alone in the shooting gallery? Why, you know he doesn't even know how to handle a gun.
He doesn't? You see these 2 holes in the hat? He was aiming for my eye. He missed.
That's no way to speak about our Rodney. Mm. He's a very sweet child. Mm.
Sweet child. You know that kid makes Jack the Ripper look like Peter Pan?
Look, you better go get him. You know, he might have an accident.
Oh, how fortunate can we be?
Stand back, everybody! Get out of the way! I'll handle it!
Shoot your mommy.
What a stupid dame, huh, Pop? I'd shoot her right in the head if I wanted.
That's no way to talk about your mother.
Oh, hey, Pop, huh? That's something, ain't it, Pop? Wow, zippity-doo-dah, huh, Pop?
Just an average girl.
An average girl? If that's an average girl, you're married to a boy.
Oh, shut up.
Wow, crazy.
All right, come on, let's go home.
Just a second. You get the idea. I'm supposed to be a 9-year-old kid. 9-year-old kids don't know about these things, you know? But when I was really 9-year-old, I could tell you some experiences. I went with this one kid.
Go!
Oh, you push me around, Daddy. Now, cut it out. I'm one of you. Cut it out.
Let's go home. Come on, let's go home.
What are you making that kid cry for? Give him some money. Don't you know it's Father's Day?
Yeah, it's Father's Day.
I'm not his father.
You're my father. Please let me play the games. Oh, Daddy, darling, please let me play the games, Daddy.
All right. Now let's play it. Thank you. I think I have some change.
Thank you. You're okay. A good daddy. Oh, boy, are you a terrific daddy. Oh, I love you, Daddy. Oh, boy, what a terrific daddy you are, boy. What a daddy I got. The best daddy in the whole world.
Very affectionate kid.
Wow! Wow! Holy cow! There it is right there. Bojo, you.
Hey, you're too young to be looking at that.
You're too old, Pop. Wow! Don't tell me I'll talk you now. Boy, that's terrific, Daddy.
That's good, huh?
Wow!
Yeah? Who are you looking at?
Kate Smith.
For you. Now, come on, let's go home.
Oh, no, Daddy, please, let me stay here. I want to play some more games, Daddy.
Let's go home.
Oh, no, Daddy, please. Oh, let me play this one game.
No.
Please, Daddy, let me play this one game.
You come to go home?
Yeah, right after this game.
All right, here.
Oh, what a terrific game. Why am I terrific
game? Oh, I love you, Daddy. Because you're the best daddy in the world.
Oh, I love you, Daddy.
All right. Okay, play the machine.
All right, thank you, Daddy. I'll put the money in and I'll play.
Go ahead.
This kid got me a fight.
That's easy, Rodney.
I don't want to play that. That's
play it. Easy. Go ahead. Put the next one. Go ahead. You can do it. Come on. Come on, boy.
I don't like that game, Daddy.
Yeah, me. I don't want to play. Kid, come here. Come on, I'll give you a free ride. You do it again. Show this boy. Go ahead.
No, That's terrific, kid. That's terrific. Boy, that was terrific.
Now, come on, do it. Ooh, you got it now. Come on, full strength. You're like your pop. Come on. Just like your pop.
Out of fight and a fight.
Let go. Let go.
Let go, my kid. Let go, my kid.
I don't like that game, Daddy.
You don't like it? I'm going to take you home.
Oh, no, Daddy. Please, let me play one more. Oh, let me play this game, please, Daddy. Let me play this game, Daddy. Please,
right.
Let me.
All right, there. Play
oh,
it.
Thank you, Daddy. Oh,
look at that beautiful lighter. Let me play it.
No.
Daddy, let me. I need some change. Hey, got some change there? Ah, the lighter. Cigarette lighter. Oh, over, over. Oh, now down, down. That's it. Cigarette lighter. Get it, get it. That's what I want, the cigarette lighter. Get it. Drop it in the hole there. Drop it. Okay, come on. Lay down. Cigarette lighter. Cigarette lighter. Yeah, that's it. Get it. Get it. Up. Where are you? What's your idea?
Rodney, get out of there.
Oh, I was only fooling, Daddy.
Get out of there.
I can't. My arm's stuck, Daddy. Don't be mad.
It's stuck?
Yeah, I can't get it out, Daddy.
All right, my arm is stuck.
Oh, help. Oh, help, Daddy.
What's going on here?
Rodney. I was just helping my kid. He had his hand stuck in the thing. I wasn't sitting on anything.
How can you be so low? Me, a type. Oh, just a weight.
Crazy.
Me taking from here, he had it all planned. Mister, he has a car with the four guys with the masks, they got the guns, and they're gonna kill all the fellas.
No. Look, buddy, I'll give you the money for the don't be upset. I'll give you the money. Oh, I wish I knew which pocket I had in. Oh, I got it. All the money. There you are.
You want to be ashamed of yourself?
Yes, you want to be ashamed, you crazy mixed up dad.
I'll take
him on home. It's all right.
No, I don't want to go home.
Come on, let's go home.
No, please, Daddy, let me play one more. Tell him. No. Let me play one more machine, please, Daddy.
You promise to go home?
Yes, after this, I promise to go home. I swear, please, let me.
Oh, all right, there.
Oh, what a terrific daddy! Oh, boy, help me. What a terrific... Oh, I love my daddy. Oh, boy, what...
Oh, what a daddy. Oh, such a precious...
Oh, what a daddy. I love this daddy. Mm.
All right.
I'm
going
to play this machine over here.
Go.
Thank you very much.
Go.
I'm
going
to play this machine.
All right, but let me warn you. Be careful. Don't tilt the machine.
Good, good, good.
No, I won't.
Come on. Easy.
I didn't win.
Well, you gotta play it very gentle like. Look, watch, real easy so you don't tilt the machine. Look, watch, real easy. You know, nice and easy.
Did I warn you?
He did it.
He did it.
I'm telling you, be careful. Don't tilt the machine.
Don't tilt the machine.
Oh, my God, don't tilt the machine.
You play it too hard, Daddy. You gotta be very easy with the machine, you see? You gotta be very, very delicate and just roll it nice and easy. I lost again!
Oh, I'll show you how to play it. Look, watch. Easy, very gentle, like.
I didn't even touch it!
He killed it! He killed it!
I didn't even touch it!
Very, very delicate with these machines. Give me a nickel, Daddy.
Yeah,
you gotta be
very,
very delicate. Now watch very closely. You gotta go very easy.
Okay, now let it go. Let this thing go.
Rodney, let it go. You're gonna bust the whole thing, Rodney.
Rodney, listen.
Easy, Rodney.
No, play one more machine.
No, Daddy, I was only fooling.
Play one more machine.
You want me to play another one?
Yeah.
All right, I will.
Ooh, what a kid. What a nice kid. Ooh, ooh, what a kid. Oh, what a good kid.
Yeah,
oh.
You're right.
Okay, now just spread it apart.
Spread it?
Yeah.
When it comes to complexion beauty, American schoolgirls really know what they're talking about. Catherine Bowling reports.
For a softer, smoother, brighter skin, that schoolgirl complexion look, I use Palmolive soap.
Anne Carmichael reports.
100% mild Palmolive actually brings out beauty while it cleans your skin.
Yes, for softer, smoother, brighter skin, change today to Palmolive's beauty plan. Gently massage Palmolive's 100% mild, pure lather onto your skin for 60 seconds three times a day. Then rinse and pat dry. Within 14 days, you can have softer, smoother, brighter skin. That schoolgirl complexion look. And 36 leading skin specialists have proved it. Prove that Palmolive's beauty plan is far better for your skin than just average care with any leading toilet soap. Proved it can bring you softer, smoother, brighter skin. That schoolgirl complexion look. For 100% mild palm olive gives you everything you need for gentle beauty care. And remember, nature's chlorophyll is in every cake of palm olive soap. Nature's chlorophyll is what makes palm olive green. Now, a special guest, Mr. Strike It Rich himself, Warren Hull.
Oh, I like being a special guest, particularly when I have something special for you folks. And I have it right here. This is it, new Twin Power Fab. Now, you want to know what that Twin Power is that Fab's got? Well, I'll tell you. Number one, it's unbeatable cleaning power. And number two, unbeatable whitening power. That's why Twin Power Fab cleans and whitens your clothes as no other product can. And now, I want you to meet Mrs. Hayworth of the Fab Home Laundry.
Warren's absolutely right. The greatest cleaning and whitening combination in wash day history has been added to Fab. And yet, with all its twin power, Fab is milder to hands than even leading floating soaps. And what a washing job Fab does on your clothes. Starts cleaning twice as fast. Contains up to twice the active washing ingredient of any leading product. Fab gets clothes really clean. There's no dulling soap scum. Your washable colors look brighter.
And it whitens?
And how it whitens.
Well, Fab contains Colgate's exclusive whitening ingredient for unbeatable whitening power, with or without a bleach.
That's right.
Well, it was very nice of you to come over here, Miss Hayworth. Thanks a lot. So, friends, don't you forget now. Fab is milder to hands than even leading floating soaps. And Fab cleans and whitens your wash as no other product can. So you strike it rich now. You grab new Fab with twin power in this familiar box.
Smooth takeoff, Captain.
Thank you, Chuck. Ring for the steward. I'd like to have some coffee.
Oh, you don't want any coffee, Captain.
Chuck, I just said I want coffee. Give me some coffee.
If you get a load of what's going to bring it to you, you'll see what I mean.
Oh, why?
That new steward, he looks like an idiot.
If he's an idiot, then this plane's in trouble.
If he ain't, the sketch is in trouble.
Yeah.
Off we go into the wild view yonder. La la la. And this guy. Hello. Hello. Hello, mister. Hello. Hello, mister. Mister. Hello. Is our motto. Have a good trip. Oh, hello, Captain. I'm the new stewardess.
You're the new stewardess?
Yes, sir. My name's Herbie.
Herbie? Herbie what?
No, Herbie Wick.
Herbie Wick?
Yes, Dad wanted a Ronson. I've never been on this airline.
I'm going to tell you. What do you know about being a steward?
Oh, I know all about it. I know you have to serve food and take care of the customers and the passengers and make them comfy, cozy, and all that. I know all that stuff. I know everything about flying. Oh, you want to go halfies on a malted?
That's not a malted.
No?
That's for cufflinks. Look, listen to me for a second.
You'll have to tell me what to
do. I'm going to tell you what to do.
You're the captain. I don't know about your ship.
Sure, what a kid. Look, I'll tell you what to do. You got to greet these people. Make them happy that they're here. Say hello. Be real nice to them.
Oh, you got
to
greet them the first thing. All right. How are you?
No, no. Don't say that. Get the microphone. The microphone.
The microphone.
Yes.
Oh, all right. Jesse James.
Yeah,
that's it. All right, got it. All right, now, first thing I do
you
is...
greet him very nonchalant.
How are you?
Oh, no, don't scare him. Be very nice, gentle-like.
So oh, charming-like.
Charming.
How are you all?
Oh, no. Gosh, just be real nice. But be a man, but be very gentle.
Be a man, all
right. Yeah.
Welcome aboard!
Will you do it right?
What do you want from me? I only know one other way to talk.
All right, well, go ahead. Maybe that's it.
Now, hear this.
Oh, come on. I'll show you.
Oh, no, please. Let me try again, Captain. Let me prove my mettle.
Prove your mettle?
Yeah.
Well, here's your chancel.
Dangso. All right. We want to welcome you aboard flight 26729Q. We want you to know that we'll be flying at an altitude of 9 feet. Now, from New York to Los Angeles, we hope to arrive in L.A. a week from Tuesday. We'll stop for 3 minutes in Chicago and 7 days in Winnipeg, Illinois. We want you to know that my aunt has a motel there. Well, what do you want from me?
Do you hear those bells? Do you hear those bells?
Yes, at the elevator.
That's not an elevator.
Well, what do you want from me? I don't know. You have to tell me.
That means that you go to every individual person and see if their seat belt is fastened.
The seat
nice.
Belt is bad. Jesse James! All right, I'll find out. I'll go see. Is everything comfy with you? How's the kid? Good. And you, lady? That's all right. Oh, look at this. Whisper's mother. Where's the rocking chair?
Come on.
Oh, this man's having trouble.
Help him
out. Let's try and put this in. You have to have the seatbelt fastened. Here we go. Just, here we go.
How you doing, Herbie?
We're getting it now. Here we are. That's it. Some are tougher than others, Captain.
Get up. You're crazy.
Fasten your seatbelt.
You leave the passengers alone.
You want me to take care of the people?
Hi, Chuck.
What do you say, Captain?
Who's that, Captain?
That's my co-pilot.
Oh, the co-pilot. Sure. You know what I was thinking?
Hello, Fred.
Oh, hi, Captain.
Hi.
Who's that, Captain?
My navigator.
Oh, the co-pilot and navigator.
Yeah, the three of us. We fly the ship. The co-pilot, navigator, myself, and Captain.
Oh, just the three of you. That's yeah. All that fly it?
That's all the three of us. Yeah, what?
Oh, I see.
What's the matter?
There's only three of you, the two fellas and you?
Chuck, Fred, and me. We fly the ship.
Well, Chuck and Fred are smoking in the lounge, and you're here with me. Captain.
Well, what's the matter?
Who's watching the store?
What do you mean who's watching the store? Chuck and Fred, they're out there, they're having a smoke, and I'm here. We, and, No!
I'm really scared. Only officials are allowed in here.
You know, I think we're a half hour late. We lost some time over the Rockies now.
I think we'll pick it up between here and L.A.
Yeah.
It's about time for a bearing check, Captain.
Yeah. Give us our position there, pal.
What?
Give us our position.
The position?
Yeah.
Of 32 degrees northeast.
32 degrees northeast? Right. What happened?
I don't know.
Something wrong. Give us another reading there, buddy.
Another reading?
Yeah,
another reading?
Hurry up, we'll land
soon. All right.
What is the reading?
16 degrees over zero, northwest, north.
16 degrees over zero, northwest, north. Oh.
What's going on?
I don't know. I better get to the tower. Pilot to tower. Give us our position, please.
You doing fairly nice. You coming into Fujiyama.
Thank you very much. Oh, we're coming into Fujiyama.
Fujiyama! Oh, they'll kill me. Oh, lady, move over, lady. Lady, move over. Move over, they'll never know it's me, lady.
Enjoying your trip, Whistler's father?
Sure, it's a wonderful trip, Captain. We're having a wonderful flight. Oh, it's wonderful, wonderful. Oh. I'd like you to meet me, Dr. Kathleen. Right, we're taking her to the Fountain of Youth, Captain.
Get up out of there. I'm sorry.
Don't make me walk the plank, Captain. I'm sorry.
Please. I won't let you walk the plank. Do you know what time? It's 6 o'clock and it's time for dinner. Now, let's have some dinner here.
All right, I'm going to take care of it right now, Captain.
Okay.
All right, get the game.
Wait a minute. Who are you going to take care of first?
Well, the passengers.
The passengers?
Yeah.
No, you take care of the officers first. You go ahead and have them in the cockpit.
In a cockpit?
Yeah, what did I say?
Oh, well, where's the cockpit, Captain?
It's up front. It's up in the nose of the ship.
The nose?
Yeah, we're using my old one.
Didn't we? Oh, well, I'll start dinner, Captain. Oh, off we go. Into the wide blue yonder. Into the sky. Off we go. Into the wild blue yonder. La da la. La da la. And walking on clouds. La da da. You want to bet? La da da da. Here you are, Captain. We have your dinner. Huh, how do you like this?
A piano stool and an airplane.
Singing plane.
Yeah. Here you are, Captain. Now, we have all your food. We have chicken, and we have peas and potatoes and salad, and everything nice, Captain. Okay. Napkin over here, and get...
Oh!
Captain, no smoking while we're in flight. You know the regulations. Do you know that the last... No, I'm sorry, Captain. You don't understand. You see, the last time we were in flight, I had to... What is this? What is this, witchcraft? Now, you can't smoke on the plane, but you're a regular Houdini, aren't you, Captain? Now, let me tell you, the first thing went... Now, Captain, you want to have your dinner, or do you...
I don't feel like eating. Just give me a little champagne. This is a champagne flight, you know.
Well, I'm going to take care of it right now, I'm on it.
All right.
This is a deluxe flight, Captain, and I have to
go
get...
Go ahead, give me the champagne.
All right, I'll get the champagne. Will you excuse me?
Sure.
Thank you.
Bye.
How's the kid? Having a good flight?
Come on, what's holding up the champagne there?
I can't open it, Captain.
You can't open it? Well, put a little force there.
I can't, Captain.
Oh, let me try.
Men, listen to this special get acquainted offer. For a few days only, you can get a large tube of palm olive shaving cream free of extra cost. Yes, you get a large tube of either palm olive brushless or palm olive lather free of extra cost when you buy a giant tube at regular price. This means a saving to you of 35 cents on lather, 29 cents on brushless, and you'll treat yourself to smoother, more comfortable shaves the palm olive shaving cream way. 2,400 men tested the palm olive shaving cream way. And no matter how they shaved before, 3 out of 4 reported smoother, more comfortable, yes, more comfortable shaves. And longer lasting shaves, too. Why, even in cold or hard water, you get a close, clean shave every time. And it's an all-day shave, a shave that most men find really lasts from morning till night. So try Palm Olive Shaving Cream while you can cash in on this great Get Acquainted free offer. Remember, sale positively ends when dealer supplies of these combination packages are gone. Buy this giant tube of palm olive brushless for 47 cents and get this 29 cent tube free. Or buy the giant tube of palm olive lather for 53 cents and get this 35 cent tube
free.
Thank you very much. Thank you very kindly. You're very kind. Now we have a serious plug that we should like to make. Mr. Marty Lewis of TV Guide is a very great guy and has been very kind to both Dean and myself. We'd like you to buy the July 5th to 11th issue of TV Guide. As you can see, Dean and I are on the cover, and there's stories about Tony and Janet, Dean and myself and Patti, and everybody making home movies. We'd like you to buy it. We'd like also to say that Mr. Ernest D. Glucksman, our very wonderful producer, who's done a magnificent job working with us throughout the 3 years in television, has worked out a fabulous thing with Macy's department store, where you'll see ads in the newspapers about Dean and myself and Father's Day. The reason that Dean and I were picked the fathers of the year, I suppose, is because between us we have seven. There'll be eight soon. Jeannie's gonna have another baby. And between Dean, Jeannie, Patti, and I, let's clarify that. Between the four of us, I think that our feelings for children are unanimous. We love kids very much. And like every performer, I would like to say hello on behalf of Dean and myself to all the kids. First, Gary and Ronnie, my two imbeciles watching.
Hello, Gary, Ronnie. They walk around jerky all day.
And to Dina and Dino and Claudia and Craig and Gail, hi, from Daddy and myself. We love children, I suppose, because it's a world over thing. Everybody has them. And they're great because you can do some wonderful things with kids. You play on Sunday. I personally like to play at home on Sunday when we're not at the studio with Gary and Ronnie. We have a lot of fun, and I get kind of sentimental when it comes to kids, I suppose, because, well, Dean and I feel the same way.
Mom, I want to go home.
We both love children very much, and we both love children very much, and as I was saying, someone take, Mr. Take Care, huh? And, well, I was getting to a point because...
Give me a headache!
Oh, terrific, Sonny. And, well, Dean and I are getting... Mister, the kid, break the head. And we love our kids so much that we're taking them all to the park
give
as soon as...
Give me a headache!
It's a wonderful kid there. And, like I was saying, Sonny, let me tell you something, Sonny. You see, you must never be rude or discourteous when someone is talking.
Get me
out!
Just
if your father won't take care of you, I'll tell you, you don't make noise in a theater. People are enjoying the show. You don't just yell and carry on. Is that understood?
What are you doing to my kid?
Thank you.
Oy vey.
Ladies and gentlemen,
I wish we had another hour so we could rest.
Buddy, how much time, buddy?
29 seconds.
All we can say are these few very important things. MDA is very important, New York 8, New York. We'd like to thank Ernie Glucksman, Buddy Yorkin, Sam Fuller, Bob Masson, the entire crew here at the International Theater for making our last TV show of the season a very memorable one. For all you guys on the stage and all you people in the technical offices, we thank you from the bottom of our hearts. We're very grateful to you. And to you listening in, all we can say is good night and God bless you.
God bless you all.
Comedy Hour has been presented by Colgate Dental Cream, Palmolive Brushless Shaving Cream, new Twin Power Fast, and Palmolive Soap. Colgate Palmolive Feed Company invites you to watch Mr. and Mrs. North every week and The Big Payoff every day. Featured in tonight's cast were Jimmy Little and Marsha Walters. Be sure and tune in next week at the same time when the Colgate Comedy Hour will star Eddie Cantor with his guests Jack Benny, Dinah Shore, George Jessel, Ralph Edwards, Billy Daniel, Rubinoff and his violin, Jimmy Wallington and Ida herself. 2 weeks from tonight, your star will be Bob Hope. The Colgate Comedy Hour has been selected to be shown to our armed forces overseas. This is Don Pardo saying goodnight for the Colgate Comedy Hour, which has been presented by the Colgate Palmolive Peat Company, makers of quality products since 1806.